All right, and here we are with round one. Playing some Momir here for channelfireball.com. Hence no deck review since, you know, it's Momir. It's all basic lands. I get to make some random creatures. This mountain lost its red symbol. It's interesting. It's actually kind of sweet. I wonder why that happened. Anyway. Yeah. These mountains are awesome. There's no red symbol. I wonder what happened to that picture. That's awesome. Hopefully it still taps for red. Let's see if my opponent makes it two. He does not. And I'm just going to get rid of a forest here. There isn't a lot of double green needed. Master Decoy is not a bad one. But I would like to have some sort of card drawer come up. Because otherwise I'm eventually going to have to skip a drop to utilize this decoy. And it might be just worth doing, but I don't know. Yeah, it's hard to skip a drop when you're on the draw. So hopefully I'll get a card drawer of some sort sometime soon. Yep, like that. Ask and ye shall receive, I guess. I wonder if he'll be able to reveal some beasts to amplify this. This is why this is going to draw me cards. When it dies, you draw a card for each age counter on it. And you always get at least one. Because it gets the age counter before before you make your decision. So it's one of the few good suicidal creatures in the format. I will discard an island here. Play planes. Of course, if he gets something that bounces a creature, I'm really, really messed up. These mountains are so sweet. Just no red symbol. I don't know why that happened. And I haven't seen it before. I mean, I haven't played Momir in a few days. So it must have been something recent. Aw, haste. Well, I wouldn't have attacked anyway. Doesn't matter. Even if I had attacked, it's like, just runs in a canopy crawler. So I'm not that worried about it. Stomp Howler, okay. Fairly good card. I feel like I have a Master Decoy and I'm kind of on the back foot. Yeah. I think I'm just gonna trade here. Yeah, I am. So now I can discard two. That wouldn't work out very well. Because then I'd still only draw three next turn. And then I don't have the mana for the decoy, so... just have to let it die right now. Basically, the extra card is more important than the four damage. Time to play Plains. And... I think I'm actually going to make a 4-drop and tap Stomp Howler. Plus 2, minus 1 until EOT. That might not work so well. Flood Chaser, okay. Definitely will not be playing any islands. Let's tap Mr. Stomp Howler. All right, time to, yeah, I guess I just play Mountain and discard Island. Ooh, that guy's nice. So that's another way I can take advantage of having more land. It's unfortunate that the Stomp Howler gets to attack for free here. Because of the Spellcaster. And I think I am just going to make a 7 next turn. There are enough 7s that are really powerful that it's probably worth it. I don't know. I mean, I get to hold off 2 attackers if I make a 6. Oh, he didn't attack? Okay, well now I can make a 7 and not feel bad about it. It's kind of strange. We'll discard Plains. Ooh, alright. Now we're in business. That guy's really good. Now his ground attack is completely stifled. So I don't have to miss any time in making 8s, which is really nice. I am still taking a ping a turn from Zoran Spellcaster, which is annoying, but not game-breaking yet. So while he's thinking, I'll go over the cards a little bit. This is just a 5-5 indestructible that can make other 5 things indestructible. 6-5 regenerator. 2-2 that can become a 4-1. 4-4, 6-6, has an island home, basically. Can't attack unless the defending player has an island. And this is just a vanilla 6-5. Ooh. That guy's a beast. Luckily, he's not Trample, so I'll be able to hold him off with my Behemoth. I guess this guy's a beast. This guy's a Golem. My bad. Aw, man, I think he took a second to reread Spearbreaker Behemoth. That's a shame. Oh, wow. Now it got real. This guy makes it so that I have a mana flare, and all of my opponent's lands stay tapped for a turn when he taps them. Yep, so his Overseer grows a little bit. Next turn, I think I am just going to make a 16 rather than a 15. Oh, but I'd have to pay 2 a turn for the upkeep. That's annoying. He might just concede if he gets a bad 8, though, so we'll see. Alright, so he got a fairly bad one. Yeah, he's got no attacks. Stuff just got really bad for him. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna make a 15. And give this indestructible. And keep open white for Master Decoy, Spearbreaker Behemoth. Because this does have trample after all. So we'll do this first. Okay, my opponent had to think about that for a bit, I guess. Gotta click all this mana. Hopefully I get Emrakul and not a Tokthon Worm. Alright, the Tokthon Worm is still fine. Because I do have a... I do have ways to get it through, after all. Send in my indestructible 7/6. It's a big trampler. Sure. Doing a 16 would have gotten me a guaranteed 9/9 flyer in Draco. That's why I was talking about 16 versus 15. This turn I'll probably just do a 12 and make a bunch of guys indestructible instead. Pretty sure 12 is all good stuff. There's like Blightsteel Colossus and some sort of Eldrazi. I'm just going to make it 12. Yeah, there you go. It the betrays. That guy's fine. And let's get in there with this, this, and this. This guy's a little too small because he's got a 6-6, so. I do have a stop on my declare blockers. Okay, that's good. Sure, I'll make both of those guys indestructible. I'm surprised he isn't multi-blocking the trampler. Like, if he had blocked with the 6-5 and the 4-4 last turn, he could have saved 2 damage, for instance. And this time, if he double blocks with Crash of Rhinos and Flood Chaser, he can save damage. So now, anything short of Ketterek Leviathan is not going to bring him back, as far as I know. I guess Archon would do it. Blazing Archon would be useful too. So he could have gone for a 9 for that reason. Yeah, this doesn't matter. But it does give him a 3-3 Zoran spellcaster. I've got blockers, so I'm not worried about anything. Doesn't have trample, so sure, I'll just block with my indestructible guy. And tap down his 8-8. And then attack. I guess I get to take control of some stuff with It the Betrays. So that's sweet. can block however he likes, and he dies. Alright. No changes here. Just in case anyone is wondering, I'll sort these by name really quick. Hey, they have mountain pictures in here. Anyway, forests are my lowest these days. Then I've got 8 and 8 of islands and plains, the 11 swamps, and the rest mountains.